In this video, I will show you how to calculate the maximum achievable climb angle and the corresponding airspeed for a given aircraft. Now, the pilot cannot directly observe in the cockpit under which angle he or she is climbing because there is no instrument in the cockpit that displays this. And it is not possible to observe this angle based on external cues. In fact, when looking outside, the pilot observes the pitch attitude theta. Now, the climb angle depends on the angle of attack as well, and this cannot be observed. In fact, the angle of attack is determined by the direction of the oncoming airflow, and this is something the pilot cannot see. Now, let me give an example to illustrate this. If an aircraft flies very slowly at constant altitude, gamma will equal zero, and the pitch attitude equals the angle of attack. Now, at a low airspeed, the angle of attack should be large to have sufficient lift, and thus there should be a large pitch attitude as well. Now, imagine this aircraft has a large speed. In that situation, there is a lot of dynamic pressure contributing to the lift force. Therefore, the angle of attack can be relatively small. Now, if this aircraft would climb with a small angle, the pitch attitude is still small. So, in the high-speed climbing scenario, the pitch attitude is in fact smaller than the low-speed horizontal flight scenario, and the pitch attitude is what the pilot observes. Now, I hope this illustrates clearly that the pilot cannot observe the flight path angle itself. Therefore, it's much more convenient to tell the aircraft or the pilot at which airspeed the aircraft can climb the steepest. Then the pilot only has to look at the airspeed indicator and apply full throttle. This will even work when it's nighttime or when the aircraft is flying through clouds. Having said that, let's start with the calculation of the maximum climb angle and the corresponding airspeed. Now, the equation of motion parallel to the airspeed vector tells us that the difference between thrust and drag determines the flight path angle gamma. If we consider a given aircraft weight, then the climb angle will be maximum when this difference of thrust and drag is maximum as well. So, at which airspeed do we have the maximum difference? This can be observed in the performance diagram. Now, the aerodynamic drag has the following shape if we represent it with a parabolic lift drag polar. The shape of the curve representing the maximum thrust at various airspeeds depends on the type of propulsion system used. So, in this figure, I have indicated a generic thrust curve. But it's already obvious that the pilot should select the maximum thrust level. He or she can also select a lower thrust level, but that only brings the thrust and drag curve closer to each other. So that is not the way forward. Now, if we have this diagram for an aircraft, it is possible to determine graphically where the curves are furthest apart. In this particular example, that is right here. Now, if we measure the difference from this figure and divide it by the aircraft weight, we will find the sine of maximum climb angle. Now, that is fairly easy, isn't it? We have the aerodynamic and propulsion characteristics of the aircraft. However, there is one special situation where we can also calculate it analytically, and that is the case for a pure, idealized jet aircraft of which the maximum thrust level of the propulsion system is more or less constant and independent of airspeed. If we also indicate the drag curve in this diagram, you can see that the difference is maximum at the airspeed for minimum drag. And the minimum drag condition is one we already encountered when evaluating horizontal flight performance. In this minimum drag condition, the ideal propeller aircraft can achieve maximum range, and the idealized jet aircraft can achieve maximum endurance. The lift coefficient for this situation can be calculated from the lift drag polar. If the lift drag polar is known, CL can be determined, and consequently, the airspeed can be determined at which the maximum climb angle can be achieved. And this is done by inserting the optimal CL, which we already calculated in previous items, into the airspeed equation. If these last steps are a bit unclear, please take your time to have a second look at earlier videos about maximum range. Now finally, I would like to encourage you to try out the example question, which can be found online. And in the next video, I will have a closer look at a very special situation for maximum climb angle.